So for the third time in my anime reviewing tenure and or just in general, literally just in general, I see an anime listed as a horror genre, and it actually had me sweating. It had me scared, literally. Attack on Titan, ReZero are the only other two animes to really capture that horror element for me. Anime usually just sucks at capturing that element. I think that's something that anyone knows that is really into the community. And this show, Promised Neverland, I knew a little bit about it. I knew a little bit coming in, and wow. And I really don't want to actually hop into the synopsis. It follows three kids, Emma, Norman, and Ray. That's all I want to say, because I want you guys to actually experience this show. So if you want to, you know, come back to this video later, go ahead. But I do recommend watching it. I don't really want to hop in too much. Let's just say it takes place, in, you know, on an orphanage, and it's believed to be a safe orphanage, and people that leave are expected to go outside the walls and live their life, but that isn't quite the case. That's all I can really tell you. I want to be really vague, because I don't want to... It'll ruin the first episode for you a little bit. It'll take away. It won't ruin it, but it'll take away. So I got to start off with the main cast here right now, and I will be hopping into spoilers in the next probably minute and a half of this video, but I love the different personalities of Ray, Norman, Emma, and I just love how Emma's the one that's really the athletic one that really catches on quickly. That's the only reason why her intellect is even able to compare to Norman and Ray's, because he learns so fast. Ray, the one that's cunning and really smart, maybe even a genius as well. He may be, but he's really cunning and he understands people. He knew there's something going on that just wasn't right. He had the ominous feeling from the beginning. And Norman, who's just a genius, you know, he's someone who won't necessarily put two and two together. But if he knows it, he knows it, and he knows a lot. Unlike Ray, who's someone who can put two and two together, he can decipher things that he does not know. The unknown is something he can become knowledgeable of just by himself. That's what I kind of get from him. And Norm's just someone who knows a shit ton of stuff. So, hopping into this episode, this is a really good show. I just want to say it one more time. But hopping into this, we get to find out that one of the girls, and this is spoiler territory, her name is Connie, and she's actually going to be going outside the village, which I kind of found odd just in general, because technically you're supposed to be gone by the time you're 11. And when Connie goes with Mama, the one that's loved by all the orphanage kids, because she is Mama, she's the one that takes care of them, feeds them, reaches them, teaches them, everything in between, and they see a teddy bear, or a bunny, I should say, actually, not a teddy bear, left behind whenever Connie leaves with Mama. And little do they know, they find Connie, drowned in the back of a truck. It definitely looked as if she is drowned. She's beaten, bruised, and battered. But there's also a tree or some kind of plant growing out of her, which really has me interested, because in the ED, there's also Emma's shoes, and you see plants and stuff, everything in between. So it makes me wonder what that's trying to kind of signify. I don't know why there's a plant growing out of her. But at the same time, we get to see if there's demons along beside her looking to eat her. So that really has me wondering what's going on with the tree. And we see that the outside world is actually just it's where demons go. You know, the orphanage is just nothing but a farm. So I really find that cool to see, and it really gives you that sense of what kind of chance do a bunch of 11-year-olds and under have? You know, if the outside world is demons, or maybe it's just the fact that the orphanage is just a farm specifically for them demons, or is the world outside the walls actually just surrounded with demons now? Are people a thing of the past? That's something that I want to know. I really want to know the history of this. When did this happen? When did demons come, you know, and take over the world? Because we see all these books that the kids are reading, how they are reading about the past life, you know, different kind of clothes, animals. Well, it seems as if once you go outside the walls, there's nothing but demons there. There's nothing about monsters there. So it really makes you wonder, is the outside world ran by monsters now? Or is the outside world not ran by monsters? It's still ran by humans, but there's monsters looking shadows, kind of doing black market kind of deals. You know what I'm talking about? So it does make me wonder. I'm interested in that. And if it is filled by, you know, if the outside world is filled by demons, I don't know. But that little gate we see in the forest is also something that has me interested. Like, okay, obviously it's not a threat. You know, Ray says that. Look at that gate. Look at that fence in the forest. It's like 2 feet tall. Obviously, there's nothing dangerous about it. She probably says that to make sure they keep corralled, probably because there's just too much space they couldn't build around and block these kids in. There's just too much, and, you know, just wasn't, they're just not able to do that. Maybe there's some kind of building flaw within the place to pick the farm. Who knows? That, to the point to where they just couldn't, one, afford to build a wall way around, or two, just that climate was just, you know, the terrain was just too, maybe up and down to the point to where they just couldn't do it. Maybe the soil was too soft. Who knows? But obviously them running past that gate is probably their only chance of survival. I mean, Ray kind of foreshadowed that the gate isn't dangerous. She just doesn't want us to go past it for some odd reason. So it makes me wonder what's on the other side of that gate, because obviously if there's demons right there, the demons and our monsters would just come right over. They just, okay, we're here. Let's eat some kids. You know what I mean? They would just come right over that gate, or fence, excuse me. I know I keep calling it a gate. But the gate's only only at one spot of the whole freaking farm or whatever, orphanage. But it makes me wonder. I am interested in that. And hopefully I made it clear. I am excited. It's the first episode. I'm excited, all right? I'm excited because I was so flabbergasted. I was so surprised that anime caught the horror element. To where I may be just a tidbit up and down all over the place at the, you know, this last minute and a half. But other than that, though, to find the horror element be captured is exciting, guys. I mean, really, I'm really excited about that. I'm excited to see, you know, how they build this world. I'm excited to see how they, you know, add context and give circumstances that make up the situation these kids are in. I cannot freaking wait. I mean, it makes you wonder, I mean, what happened to their parents? Obviously, they had to come from somewhere. So where did they come from? I mean, obviously they came from their parents, but what happened to their parents? Did their parents just give them off? Did the monsters kill their parents and take over the world and say, we are going to grow these children up so we can eat them? And the demons even make a comment about, no, we can't eat this Connie girl, not even a fingertip. This is for the rich. She's a delicate. She's a high-quality kind of child to eat, in her human flesh to eat. We cannot eat her. And it makes you wonder, Mama's human, so why is she associating with these monsters? At the same time, it makes you wonder, maybe she's not human. Maybe she's just putting on a human persona. I mean, you know, maybe it's just a mask outfit. We don't know the monster's abilities. We don't even know if there's magic in this world. So it does make you wonder. So, yeah. The Promised Neverland is good. It is very good. And the OP, actually, now that I look down my notes, is the last thing I need to talk about. So the OP bangs, and it bangs as if it's a shonen series. Like, the opening reminded me of My Hero Academia, just the way it's bumping and banging. It seemed like it was an action series, the way that OP was going. But I love the OP either way. I don't care. It doesn't have to be an action series. I love the OP. Actually, I believe the show is listed as a horror shonen. The other thing, I think it may have been psychological, maybe. I could see that. But at the same time, it was listed as a shonen on my anime list, so it makes me kind of second guess that. I mean, a shonen aimed at a younger demographic, I don't think little kids, 13-year-olds getting eaten by demons is what they want to try to sell to those kind of that age, because then you're just going to scare the shit out of them. So it makes me question the genre of shonen being listed in there. This seems more like a seinen that does that. So, especially seeing that girl Bruce being battered, like, and drowned, obviously killed. I mean, that's not something you want to, that shouldn't be listed as a shonen. So, as always, guys, you guys have been hexed. Be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter @X25. I will see you guys next time. Peace. Hope you guys enjoyed the video.